Hello people, hope you are having a great day, and today I'm gonna show you how to make an air gun spring compressor so you can do your maintenance and your tuning in a safe way. And to start with is picking a good quality of wood that is hard and solid with not too many of these knots in there. So to start off with, this long plank is 90 centimeters long, that's 3.5 feet, it's 9 centimeters wide, and that's about 3.5 inch, and all the wood is cut from one long plank, and that's all about 3 centimeters thick, and that's 1.3 inch. I don't know if I'm saying it correctly, but this is how I'm measuring it. So when you cut this plank of 90 centimeters, then you need two wooden blocks. These are 16 centimeters long, and that's about 6.5 inch, and they are 9 centimeters high, the same as the width, of course, and that's 3.5 inch. Then you need this one piece in the middle, that's 10 centimeters long, and that's about 4 inch, and it's a little bit lower than all the others, we made it a little bit smaller. It's 8 centimeters high, and that's about 3.2 inch, like 3.25. I don't know exactly how you're telling this, explaining this, but yeah, it's not as precise as millimeters and centimeters. Okay. When you make those pieces, you need two custom pieces that are made. I will make a picture and put all the carvings measurements right there. You can find those pictures and description on my blog. Everything will be there on writing, so you can find everything back and you can read it again. With some cool pictures, should be making it easier for you to create and to make a similar air gun spring compressor. The first custom block, you place this at 27 centimeters from the beginning, that's about 10.5 inch. The second custom block, you will place this at 46.5 centimeters, and that's 18.5 inch. Then you need to create a small wooden piece, and I will put the writings down on my blog about how high it is, how wide, but it's not so long and not so big, but it needs to be precise so that you can line out your iron screw tread bar. It needs to be really aligned to keep this not to move up or down. It needs to be nice and flat sliding over the wood, and a few extra pieces that help to keep the iron screw tread bar in its place are these brackets. Yeah, I got two brackets just for the exact height. And then I got these two pieces. I don't know the names, I'm real sorry, but this is what makes it move forward and backwards while I spin the bar. If you want to see it in action, check one of my movies of the assembly or assembly of my air rifle, and you will see it in action and see it really works. Then I use an end piece of a curtain rack, so that is for, you see there's a piece sticking out at the end and it's crooked, it's not even, it's not flat, so I need something where I could put it in where it would stay and sit on its place. So if you can't find something, then try to find something really bigger than your air rifle pistol, and then fill it up with something so you can keep it nice steady on its place. And another nice thing about this air gun spring compressor is that your barrel will be resting on here. There will be no pressure, nothing at all that can perhaps bend or this form your barrel is something you need to avoid by any chance. So the only real pressure will be on the piston and not on the barrel. But to continue, how to create this is that you need two other wooden blocks. These are 10 by 9 long and same height, same width and same thickness, so from one plank. You use two L plates, one on each side, screw it up real tight. These L plates are 4 by 4 centimeters, no, 10 by 10 centimeters. This is 4 inch and this is 4 inch. The iron screw bar that is 45 centimeters long, and that makes about 18.5 inch. Then you need two end nuts so you don't hurt yourself while using it. Then you need a washer to keep it nice and there, a nut to fill up the idle space. Same here, got a few nuts and a handle, making it easier to spin it around, moving it forwards and backwards. And see, there's a hole there. Of course, there's a hole through the L, so it will keep moving. And it's all locked up and tight very hard. It's the same with the screws on the lower sides. They are very long screws. To be sure everything is really tight, I even use some extra wood glue in between, because you don't want anything of this to fail when you're using it. I've seen too many accidents happen and some people really hurt themselves. So be safe, buy or make your own spring compressor. It's really handy, comes really in handy for your maintenance, and it's really a lot safer and doesn't even have to cost that much to create. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then please give it a like. If you have any questions, you can always leave a comment and I will come back to you. And have a great weekend. Ciao.